Hello everyone, I am Siddhi Arora. I am a student of second year architecture college in BNCA, Pune. I have designed a visitor center in Capitol complex. This was just a rough concept sheet which I derived. I wanted to construct within the unconstructed and the trees that were already existing and created my building there. So I went with the less is more and built minimum for the maximum function. And then I roughly first did the site analysis where I took a site. This was the site. Here I counted the trees and sorted out which were the trees that are going to be helpful for my design. Also, I calculated the sun path. I saw the north orientation, the wind direction, and the minimum maximum rainfall, and all these constraints which are going to help in designing. About the climate analysis of the site, I took my model and I placed it oriented according to what I have thought of. Placing it in the northeastern and southwestern directions so that the longer and the longer sides are on north and south aligned, which is well suited for any building so that it is climatically responsive. Also, seeing the sun path, which is from northeast to southwest from the south side going here, and the winds are coming from the northwest, because of which it is creating a very nice ventilation across the whole the complex that I have made, the composition. Also, I've calculated the temperatures. It was highest in June, 33.2 degrees Celsius, and in winters it is like 13.5 degrees Celsius in January. Because of this, I thought that using the material, concrete would be suited for the location. And so I decided to go on calculations for my concrete type and the assemblies that I can use. I went with facade to facade analyzing my design. So on reading the northeast facade, I saw how the tree that was existing there was shading my opening, because of which I had no reason to create an extra shading device, because on the harsher rays, whenever the harsher rays were coming on the window or the doors, there were no need for the shading device, because already the area was shaded. The area was already in the shadow of the tree that was coming there. So because of that, I came up with no shading here. And then going to the southwest facade, here also, because of a tree present there, this tree here in this northeast facade, the shadow of this tree was prevalent, and in the southwest facade, this tree's shadow was prevalent, because of which my facade and this face was shaded well and no harsh sunlight was coming in. Only the concern was what to do about the heat that is coming from the top when the sun is at the top. So coming over to that, I decided to take a wall assembly and the roof assembly, which is the 3D eco wall. It is going to trap my heat and not let it come inside, and also maintain the comfort of the building within. I have oriented my building northwest southeast, because of which the well ventilation is there, and also the sun path is also corresponding to this building design. So this is what I have incorporated in my design. The wind is coming from here and circling here and traveling from this place, and it is getting a channel to go from here. Here also coming inside, it is an opening and going from here, finally making the whole place aerated. I studied the shadow of my complex at two different times of the day. One was in the morning time, the yellow light, and the yellow color is depicting how and what part of the place is shaded in the morning time, and the green depicts in the afternoon. So this is how the trees and the buildings are relating to each other in the point of making shadows and keeping the place comfortable. Before considering all the climatic data and all the and after making after being known to all these concepts and all these analyzing myself that what are we trying to do with this concept, what are we trying to make out of this knowledge, is that why are we using it? So that we can minimize the energy and we can find ways to minimize that energy. And finding ways is not just constructed in creating something that is energy efficient. Why not just create less to make it energy efficient? Seeing for the future, if I say I have to consider these things, I would probably have to. Because as we can see, this was a site constraint that we were given the capital complex. There was a lot of space. But when we see of the present day cities and the areas, there is a very less space and a very much demand. And for that, we must be very well known to all these concepts and all the data and how to implement it in our design so that we can save energy for the future generation and be sustainable.